Guys, so good morning. Today we're going to go ahead and get started with our new strand, which is basically understanding mood of a particular story. So we're going to get started with our opening routine before I get into depth with that. So in here it says, analyze the different medias and explain how they make you feel. So you're going to look at the different medias. I have three different things. I'm going to just start with number one. I'm going to give you guys about 30 seconds in between to look at the picture. You tell me in one or two sentences, how do you feel when looking at this picture? So number one is a casket, right? So you're going to write in your notebook right now for 30 seconds, how does looking at this casket make you feel? There's absolutely no talking. All right, so begin now. How does looking at this casket make you feel? So you should be writing. The date does not matter. Your name does not matter because it's your notebook. You have 5 seconds left to talk about or write down how those looking at a casket make you feel. Alright, number two. Looking at this ocean. Tell me, how does looking at this ocean make you feel? How does looking at this ocean make you guys feel? 30 seconds. Alright, and the last one is going to be a little different. We're going to listen to a song, and you're going to tell me, how does listening to this song make you feel? Today's opening routine is going to lead into exactly what we're going to study today. So again, I told you guys that we're gonna be looking at mood, all right? So you probably think, well, Ms. Brent, why do I need to understand mood? Why is it important? Why are we even learning about mood? Guys, you need to understand that anytime you read a poem, book, story, watch media, advertisement, the author is always trying to make you feel a particular type of way. All right, so it's important for you guys to be able to identify the mood of a piece of text, media, anything, because the author is always trying to invoke a particular type of feeling on you. So we're gonna go ahead and get into whole groups, which means that you're not gonna turn into a new paper in a book, and we're gonna take some notes really quick. All right? All right, real quick, it says it's going to be very quick and simple. We're not going to drain it out. We're going to take these notes. We're going to understand it and put it into practice. I'm just trying to figure out who's talking when I'm talking. All right, so we're going to do blank sheet of paper, and we're talking our paper, What is Mood? So the title of today's whole group is What is Mood? You should be writing that down on your table of contents. What is Mood? Alright. And just quickly, guys, how many of you guys ever woke up like on the wrong side of the bed? Like you just woke up, it's not feeling it. Right? And let's say you get up and you're trying to get ready, you come to school, and one of your friends are trying to play with you. What is the first thing you say? Mood. Okay, mood. Or you may say, I'm not in the mood. I'm not in the mood today. Today's kind of day, I'm not in the mood. Right? Or sometimes, well, I don't have you guys for my aunt days, but on my aunt days, when my kids come in, my students come in very loud, I say, guess what, guys? Today, Ms. Brent is not in the mood. That means I'm not filling up your information. You can go ahead and freeze the screen. Go ahead, guys, and copy this chart down in your notebooks. You have approximately 4 minutes. Alexis, lights, please. Do we have the top copying this down? No. And when you're finished copying the charts out, open your books to page 616 so I know that we are ready to start. Open your books to page 616 when you're finished so I know that we are ready to start. Say aye when you're finished.
Aye.
Okay, so I just have a couple of books open. By the way, Caesar has opened his book. By the way, Ivan has opened his book. 616, guys. 10 seconds left, so make sure you get this simple chart copied on your paper. All right, pencils down. Quick refresh to make sure that we're all on the same page. What are we going to be studying today?
Mood.
And what is mood?
How
does story make you feel? Excellent. All right, pencils down, guys. Pencils down. All right. So everyone should be on what page?
616.
6:16. Okay. So you know how we start our anytime we start a new strand and we read a new story, we read the story the first time just to read it, to make sure that we understand. So of course, before we even get into filling out this chart to determine the mood of the poem, we first need to read it for a very first read. Alright? So you guys know that the way I do it in here is that where I stop, you guys say the word. So I'm gonna read it to you guys one time fully. And then we're gonna do a second read that's called close reading. We're gonna do a second read. And don't you step down on them steps, cause it finds it kinda hard. Don't you fall now, the eyes are still going, honey. Eyes are still climbing. And life for me ain't been no crystal stair. Okay, so that was the first read. Now we're gonna read it again. Why stop you guys, we're gonna say the word, okay? All right, Mother to Son by Langston Hughes. Well, son, I tell you, life for me ain't been no crystal.
Stair.
It has tacks in it, and splinters, and boards. In place with no carpet on the floor.
Stair.
But all the time, I've been climbing.
Stair.
And reaching.
Stair.
And turning.
Stair.
And sometimes going to the dark when there ain't been no
light.
So boy, don't you turn.
Stair.
Don't you sit down on them steps cause you find it kinda hard. Don't you fall now, but I'm still going. I'm still climbing. And life for me ain't been no crystal.
Yeah.
All right. So really quick, who's the speaker in the poem? The mom. And who is she talking to? Her son. All right, these three words. Oh, and splinters. Sorry, I have four. Splinters. What is a splinter? A piece of wood, and then you get it stuck in your hand or your foot, and it really, really hurts, right? So I'm looking at all of these words, tax, boards torn up, bear, splinter, and now I'm thinking, how do these words make me feel? What type of mood do these words put me in?
Painful.
Painful, very good. So right now, the mood of the poem is what? Into number two. Demire's gonna read lines. She's gonna read lines 8 to lines 14. Alright? Ah, Zamira. Come on.
But all the time I've been climbing on and reaching landings and turning corners and sometimes going in the dark. Where there ain't been no light, so boy, don't you turn back.
Very good. So we have to pick words out of here. What words would we choose? Turning back, okay? So there's no turning back, right? Because think about it. When you turn back to something, how does that make you feel? Like a quitter, very good. IBO, it makes you feel like a quitter. All right, here we go.
This great word wants to add up.
So, we're gonna pull out the word, no turning back. You should be writing it down in your truck right now. So, we're looking at lines 8. 8 through 14. And the word we chose is no turning back. Okay. What else? I heard someone else say, I think I heard Edgar say a good phrase too. Which one, what words would you pull out, Edgar?
Where ain't
been no light. Okay, so no light. What else though? Huh?
Climbing on,
very good. Very good, climbing on. And reaching landings, right? So, what type of feeling do we get here? How do these words make you feel? She said, to persevere.
Marco, call it to me.
Okay.
Ivan.
To keep going.
Ivan.
Very good. Are there any questions on completing this chart? All right. So you're gonna read the last few lines 15 through 20. You guys are gonna read them independently. All right, you guys, I'm gonna turn the lights on. You guys have 5 minutes.